These are just some of the emails Mining Watch Canada got. They're from the summer of 2012 when Mexican landowners and mine workers set up a blockade in a protest camp at an entrance to Exelon's mine in Durango. Some of the miners had concerns about their working conditions. Landowners were upset because they say Exelon wasn't meeting its contractual obligations, for example, to build a water treatment plant. Now, critics say the Canadian embassy may have gone too far in protecting Exelon's interests. In one email, the ambassador agreed to a meeting with the protesters to listen, possibly to gather intel helpful to the company. Others show the embassy arranged meetings with Mexican authorities on behalf of Exelon.
We see the trade commissioner wishing the company well. So with full knowledge that the army and police were going to move in, the embassy was also willing to tolerate the use of armed repression in order to shut down the Ejidos protest.
In a statement, Exelon President Brendan Cahill says, while the embassy was helpful in making introductions and scheduling two meetings with the governor of Durango, no information was relayed through the embassy. A spokesperson for the Department of Foreign Affairs, Trade and Development says there's no merit in the suggestion that Canadian officials in Mexico acted in a way that didn't reflect the highest ethical standards and Canadian values, and that the Government of Canada expects all Canadian companies operating abroad to follow all applicable laws. Karen Pauls, CBC News, Winnipeg.